everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. This is a team that comes into the game wishing there was more on the line, but the reality is they're just playing out the string at this point. Still, despite their disappointing season, you can be sure they'll be giving it their all here.
It's the Bengals going up against the Chiefs.
So let's get you out to Kansas City as we say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Kansas City Chiefs. Throwing here to start the drive. Brought in here by Tyler Eifert. A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Looking right sideline. That's complete. And way in for a Cincinnati score. Their dangerous wide receiver, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. This is taken near the 13. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Shift together here from the D-line. So we've got encroachment, and that's a free 5 yards.
Too easy for the offense. A bit of impatience by the defense on that one.
Here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Again, it's Bell, and he'll get this up only to about the 33. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and Travis Kelce will be key.
What a tremendous weapon he is, especially in the red zone. Knows how to find the end zone when running his routes.
Green, 39!
Cousins from the gun on third, and he's got his man on the out route. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Oh, a design run for their wideout. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I'm not sure that you'd call it a trick play, but they definitely showed some imagination there. I wouldn't be surprised if they want to come back and show this play a few more times before this one is over.
Here's Cousins. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And here are the defensive starters. In your old position, you get to talk about the secondary.
The best athletes on the field, Brandon.
Ah, debatable.
Well, we'll see how this goes today. I love the way you put my guys down. But you know this, they've got to cover and they have to tackle. They have a heck of a task in front of them in this game.
T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. And that brings up fourth down. Here's the Chiefs punter now. as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. Taken in at the 11. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Bengals take possession. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Now it appears we've got a Chief moving pretty gingerly down there. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. They'll come out in the pistol. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Buying time to his left. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. So they don't get anything out of that completion. I guess when you roll out of the pocket like he did there to the left, if you're going to throw it, you better gain some yardage.
Now, can you just hear the old school coaches right now? You threw it for no yard? They don't want the ball in the air unless something positive is going to happen downfield. In that case, they'd rather have the quarterback try and run it himself. Just take care of the ball. If nothing else, just slide and get down.
And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Caught Eifert over the middle. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. And I think Eifert may be in some pain. Staying down following that. Step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. The Bengals bring out their punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Pulled in at the 24. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field, as opposed to sudden change after a turnover and wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. Kelce out in the slot right.
Let's go!
Now a second down throw for Cousins. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. That catch good for five. It's third down.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion. On third down, Cousins. And he will find his man on the outside. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field,
but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time, and it paid off on that play.
Now a first down carry by Bell, and he's got this one just across midfield to the 49. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
All right, here we go. Blue landing. Gone, gone. Gone, gone.
On 2nd down, it's Bell. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Hilton, the lone receiver, right.
All right, here we go. 3-19!
Play action now. Cousins. Serve out. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. J.J. Watt in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a 4th down. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Underneath here to Hill. It's a gain of 5, and it'll be a 2nd down. First drive for this offense today, and our first chance to get a look at Tyler Eifert.
And he's part of the new wave of tight ends in the NFL. They use him in every position, sometimes even by themselves as a wide receiver.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A big play there. 79 yards. And the Bengals add on to their lead. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Limited running room as he'll get about 3 to the 21. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon as the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the 2nd quarter. They've got it 2nd and 6 to start things out. Yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game, really at the point of attack. The offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe you keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
And this one caught by Travis Kelce. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They'd have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments. But they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude. But I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul-searching now.
I would say so. They need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot
position.
More than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
He'll come out in the pistol. On the counter, here's Bell. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. He lost four there, and it's third down.
There's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Third and long for Cousins. And this is going to be incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and that just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
No gain on the play there. Second down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Back to throw now on second and 10. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll lead here to a third down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
He'll look to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Tyler Kroft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. And now it's fourth down. The Bengals bring out their punter now, standing just about on his own goal line. Oh, it's a wobbler here. Taking on the midfield logo. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. And now here comes Kansas City. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. After the penalty, it's Bell. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Kelce out in the slot right.
Hurry up, here we go.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to bring up a third down.
All right, here we go. Green three.
Now Cousins. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. Khalil Mack in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Possession goes over here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
But when it all comes together and you get the field goal block that's been designed, that's been drawn up, everyone has to feel good about on that side of the ball. How about that one there? To the left side, knew what they had. That's where they wanted to be. And they got their designated guy turned first.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And, oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that's going to lead to a third down.
What a catch, and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
And those gloves, they do have a little grip to them.
They have that little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here. And oh, this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. It'll be a pickup of 12 yards. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
They're going to look to throw. It's brought in by Kevin White. 20 yards on the pickup there. And the Bengals are going to have a first down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this. First down carry, it's Hill, and he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense, and what a big-time play there.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon. It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. He'll try again with the arm here on second down, eluding the pressure right. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make it third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Out of the gun now on third down. That's caught at the 1. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your...
And he is in! Touchdown, Bengals! It's their quarterback with touchdown number 23 here on the year, and the Bengals are able to grow their lead.
I heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. And they will line up now for the two-point try. They'll try and throw for it. And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by 2 more. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
He's going to air one out. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Cousins on the right side. It's Hilton with a catch. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
When you decide to run a hitch route, it really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And where the ball is now, you got the field goal pretty much in the bag. Now do you try for the end zone a couple of times?
I don't think there's any question about it. You might get a gift of 6 points rather than the 3 that you just noted that you feel like you already have. Be aggressive. Go after it and try
to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the free safety, Eric Berry. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And now here comes Kansas City. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
They come out here in the eye. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll probably wish he reconsidered here. It'll cost him 10 yards now with a new rule as he's down at the 15-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Cousins now on second down. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he is out of bounds, getting it just shy of the 35. They give him 14 yards that time and a flash shut of downs.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Well, it hasn't been a whole lot of fun for Le'Veon Bell in this ball game, trying to find room to run the ball. I'm sure they're going to have to change some things up because he's so versatile. They've got to get the ball in his hand somehow and create some space because they're losing this game.
Well, and defensively, you've got to key in on Bell, make him the focal point to stop, and they've been able to do that.
And he has gotten better every year he's been in the league, always adding something to his game, one of the premier runners in the NFL.
They'll go again with Bell. And a gadget package there won't do much for him. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Now Cousins. But he's got his man, Hilton. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Well, we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one. All right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the free safety, Eric Berry. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Here's Cousins, flushed out right. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
A first down carry now for Miller. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Comes nowhere to escape, and he goes down. J.J. Watt in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Hurry up, here we go.
Off the play fake, Cousins. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Khalil Mack in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. It's a pickup of 21, and it'll give the Bengals a first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw, and he fires one incomplete. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here, second down and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks, and now the ball's out, fumble near midfield, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And it's a huge return as he brings us all the way back down to the 15-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. Underneath here to Hill. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
They'll look to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route,
I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver?
And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Bengals add on to their lead. So he missed his first two, but this time it's good, and that'll extend the lead. The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
Watch left, watch left, watch left. Stop right there.
They come out here in the eye.
Detroit!
Now Bell. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain. One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
On third down, Cousins. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins, and he's got his man on the out route. 5 yards on the pickup, and on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. And now they're in the hurry up.
Here we go.
Play fake here on first down. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. We're back now in KC. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. So this brings up a 2nd and 2. They go play action. Cousins. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Cousins now to throw on first down. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. Now it's 2nd and 7.
Here we go now. Blue landing.
Cousins again. He's got it to Hilton. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
That was a really nice play, be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free and make the hit on the run.
The Bengal pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. J.J. Watt in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Here's Cousins. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Khalil Mack. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. 15 yards through the air and a first down. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short.
Really tough drive, but that run help salvage something there, because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back, and now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
I don't know about you, partner, but on second and inches, a lot of the times I'm leery about the offensive guys thinking about taking a shot downtown. Instead, they just hand it to the big man and let him rumble forward for a first down.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They'll look to throw now on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. A dump off now to Hill. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And this is incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. What's like that in just about every position? And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Another pistol look here. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Tyler Croft, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals have got it on cruise control. And can you believe it? He misses another one, his third so far. The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. And now here comes Kansas City. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. And the play goes. For 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. They come up in an offset eye. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now a second down throw for Cousins. Caught left side by Hilton. T.Y. Hilton, nobody to beat. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. T.Y. Hilton, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. And that'll cut the lead down to 26. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. After the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the upmen.
Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Here's Bell. Stays on his feet. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
Oftentimes when you're not winning at the point of attack for an offensive line, maybe they're getting out physical. Spread things out a little bit, make it more of a one-on-one blocking scheme. Then you don't have to win it physically. You just have to win it by position. That may open things up for your running backs.
Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. And a long way to go for the offense here on second down. Kelce out in the slot right. Cousins now on second down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they do get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three.
And depending on the type of screen call, especially when you're throwing it with one of your wideouts, it's different blocking. Sometimes you get great blocking from the other wide receivers helping you. And how about sometimes getting it from the offensive lineman who sell it like a regular screen pass and then get out in front of the receiver and help him get downfield.
Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
You got to be ready for anything when you play defense against this head coach. That is not something you'd expect to see here in the red zone, but it winds up getting him a few yards.
And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Kirk Cousins with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Chiefs are able to draw a bit closer. So with second and goal, still had a couple of downs to work with. They tried to sneak, and they got in.
I like the idea that they did it early in the down and distance count. Second down as opposed to waiting later on. I think it fooled them a little bit, but how about the push they got up front to get the quarterback through?
Big push and a touchdown to boot. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And this is going to be snuffed out. The Bengals recover. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation. And now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Underneath here to Hill. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Looks like he'll throw here. Muscles him off. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now here's a defense. Defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now here comes Kansas City. They're down big here late. I don't know. Just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge. And someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Hurry up, here we go. Detroit! Back to the Philly, here we go.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. And just a simple, basic neutral zone infraction here, partner.
Yeah, when you're ready to launch and go get the quarterback, sometimes you take off a bit too fast.
We'll see Kelce in the slot to the left. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. 18 yards on the pickup there. And it'll give the Chiefs a first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Cousins. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A great read and it's picked off. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Now this Bengals offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing, the kneel-down formation, the victory formation. We've got it.
And now here is another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And that will light a finish to this ball game. Well, Charles, it's great to win at home in the NFL. When you win on the road, it's a little extra special, isn't it?
It is because, let's face it, in most cases, you're not expected to go on the road and win in the National Football League. It just doesn't usually compute. So to get out there, get that done, and then head back to your city with one in the victory column, Oh, that's a fantastic feeling.
So for the Bengals, they continue to put themselves in position for a first-round bye as they move to 8-2. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Oakland to take on the Raiders. Meanwhile, for the Chiefs, they come back to the pack a bit as their record falls to 7-3. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel to Denver to take on the Broncos. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.
3 chains. Ow. Caught up in my, put your head on backwards, then skate off after engaging laughter about what just happened. Napkins get sent to mammies, is that too graphic? Catch you in traffic, you sitting dappy like stealing candy. My ceiling's absent, my wheels are massive, my friends assassins. All of us, our mothers queens and our women dancers. My river's rapping, my fin is splashing, my gills are flapping. I bit some matches, then sip some thing and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping, no finger snapping, them packing. Y'all slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking, I'm showing passion. Know what I mean, see, I'm the king like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard, somebody call the captain. And when it comes to getting checks, I always want the fat ones. I'm so I can sing to a chandelier. My flow a glass of spade and yours a candle.
Too many buttons. Not enough these fucking, the SWAT is coming. Shoulder, no shoulder shrugging. That's your nugget. Stick it like acupuncture and Magnus honey. Knock on the side door 3 times and have your money. Or get to stepping like Kappa stomping. I slap. I'm having lunch with Italian Sonny. Don't ask the subject. Lord, why you took rabbit from me? He say don't ask me nothing. Too many bodies, too many bundles. Not enough these bugging. I heard they stung you. It's gonna be trouble. We come through and catch you while you cuddle. Barrels like tunnels. Don't even mumble.
I'm back to balling. I'm in the back. Pull on the scene and the queen playing past Detroit. Ready turkey, spaghetti, and castor oil. Turn your guillotine to a fashion show. In 4 minutes, I turn this into forensics in a foreign car with a foreign. It's long-winded, paper long, and you taking long. You just don't get it. Hung the phone up on Say Tony, want a song with me. Hotter than Mississippi, the summer of the 1950s. In a van full of some white. Get pulled over for swerving like high officer. When he asked me why I was swerving, I'm officer.
I can make it bounce by myself. 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 I can make it bounce by myself.
Got a mansion, a condo, a cabin, I sleep in my phantom. Dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern. I ring your Saturn. I'm your madam, she get and I shake the ladder. I make her take up and gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games. I straight get at them. I'm on a all day like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when the Cayman Islands dancer. If I don't get the call first, I have a temper tantrum. I'm innovative, I demonstrated this. Play it. I don't care if you owe me it. You need to pay me. I kiss you later. Kiss you later. Then kiss the baby. Get situated. Get keys off table and leave it. I really made it. Get it made. Won't wrestle cause I spatula all you action figures.
These tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls. They say, yeah.
I'm doing this for L. When I go, I'ma leave for the bell. I told you did like a Chevy. I want a Ferrari in yellow. Just so I can match all my yellow. I've been a player since elementary. I got my balls in the penitentiary. I got a that hangs several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself. 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 I can make it bounce by myself.
Turn up. I'm breaking in. I'm at the pearly gates, but they won't let me in. I told the devil, I said, "F*** him, I ain't trying to sin." Yeah, I ain't trying to sin.
breaking in.
Long life, walk around with a long, long way, like Jesus, that
Colombiana, that's mere models like.
Yeah.
Look at the flick of that wrist. I'm feeling like Leonardo. Let me paint the picture. I might need a bottle. On the road to success, I can feel the throttle. That Michelangelo, hunters in the envelope. Type when I write. And that old man had a change of heart. Wishing knew it back from the start. Like, looked around, seen his wife on the military all over the whole compound. Soon as he seen it, I swear it, I mean it. My man was gone quicker than Vamanos. He in jail. Everyone falling like dominoes. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that with this. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I been killing that. Yeah, I been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I been flicking that wrist, looking that, feeling that, flicking that wrist.
Logic. Clockwise, counterclockwise, realest in the top five. Other four ain't rapping. I'm just repping for the side. Yeah, that's coastlines, Panama for the boat rides. Worth billions, and we ain't even need Showtime. Just money counters and kitchenware, condo with a in there. We got rich in there. Been a trophy since Hawaiian Sophie. Curry over Kobe. We shooting. Splash Brothers with the add in soap. Good fellas to my Aureliotis. Shades of blue, I hit you. Let the sky fall, let it rain on you.
Yeah, I been killing it. Yeah, I been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I been that it with this. Yeah, I been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been getting with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, looking that, feeling that, flicking that wrist.
Your inhibitions, let the beast in you just get loose. We all young, wild, and different. We can all get hit from a little. I know you're terrified by what the future lies, but there's no compromising. It's my way or the highway. We all just slave the lust, heart building, breaking trust. Don't get wild when we come out, like don't get loud when the come out. That's instant. Give up with your friends, stay. Tell they bougie, go wait in line with them lame. Talking real rap, tell them break your neck, go and bust a rhyme. Down, pass it around, hey. What with me now? We running well, hey. And nobody can, we on the town, hey. Never come down, I never come down. Lose it. I might lose it. I might lose it. Everybody got guilty pleasures. Mine just tend to catch me cases. Handcuffs, police inspections, lawyers, judges, allegations. Turn on your favorite station. You hear the same old song. I feel like dog, I'm about to drop the bomb. Blow on down, pass it around, hey. What with me now, we running well, hey. And nobody can, we on the town, hey. Never come down, I never come down. Blow on down, pass it around, hey. What with me now, we running well, hey. And nobody can, we on the town, hey. Never come down. Lose it. I might lose it. I might lose it. I might lose it. Lose it. I might lose it.